I'm going to tell you about Derek, a man who currently resides at Jakarta and whom SUFY advocates for. In the past couple of weeks, I've had the pleasure of assisting Derek to put together his story so we could share it with you today. So what is so exceptional for Derek about this day? Looking at the video and the things Derek was doing, going to the local shopping centre, purchasing some new clothes and shoes, getting his hair cut, having lunch out. Many of you are probably asking this question, what is so exceptional about ordinary everyday things that you and I do on a frequent basis? I'd like you to hold on to that thought for a minute or two, because before I talk about that, I want to give you a brief history of Derek's circumstances. Derek is a 53-year-old man who sustained a head injury approximately 16 years ago. He was admitted to the Jakarta Brackenridge facility on the 8th of July 1998. In this hospital facility, Derek has remained inappropriately accommodated in a clinical institution environment. As previously said, Jakarta comprises of two units, the Banksia unit and the Jabiru unit. When Derek was first admitted to Jakarta in 1998, he was accommodated in the Banksia unit. In 2007, he was transferred to the Jabiru unit. In the Jabiru unit, the only space that is just Derek's is his single bedroom. All the other space is communal. Derek shares a bathroom, toilet, and general living space with the other residents in Jakarta. He is homeless. Chamberlain and McKenzie define people who live in a single room without their own bathroom, kitchen, or security of tenure through a tenancy agreement as tertiary homelessness. In approximately July 2000, 2 years after Derek was first admitted to Jakarta, his slow stream of rehabilitation was ceased. It was determined at this time that no further rehabilitation outcomes were likely to be achieved. Derek was ready for discharge and to move back into the community. For this to occur, however, Derek required housing through Department of Housing and funding through Disability Services to attain the support he required to live in the community. From July 2000, staff at Jakarta, and in recent years SUFY, have made various referrals and applications on Derek's behalf for community-based accommodation and support. To this date, none of these have been successful. Consequently, Derek has been forced to stay at Jakarta 14 years longer than he has needed to. In effect, Derek has been trapped at Jakarta due to being unable to secure community-based accommodation and support. His home has become a health facility administrated by Queensland Health, operating according to a medical nursing model of care. So back to the original question, what was so exceptional about Derek's day? For 16 years, Derek has lived on the edge of society, contained in an institution that is viewed by the general community as somewhere where sick people are. Derek has been excluded and separated from his community and his social networks. With no individual funding from Disability Services and with limited funds available through Jakarta to support people to access the community, Derek spends the majority of his time at Jakarta. His days are wasted sitting in his room watching TV or outside in the communal areas. It is on a rare occasion that Derek gets to go out in the community and do ordinary things, like going shopping or eating out. Living in poverty, Derek has limited available funds to spend on himself, to buy new clothes or shoes, things of enjoyment such as CDs or DVDs. He only has a small room where he can keep his personal belongings. This room is not secure or private, leaving Derek's things at risk of damage, loss or theft. Once again, with no funding, Derek has extremely limited opportunities to go shopping. Being able to purchase something nice for himself is exceptional for Derek. Having lunch out, being able to choose where and what you're going to eat is exceptional for Derek. In Jakarta, the staff prepare the meals. Derek has no say over what and when he eats. The requirements for Derek to go out on a regular basis have been taken away from him. The practices implemented in Derek's current living arrangement means the bulk of his daily tasks are done for Derek within Jacana. Derek does not have access to a kitchen. He does not get to plan where he's going to plan what he's going to eat for the week. He does not even get to make his own tea or coffee, morning or afternoon tea. He does not do any of his own cleaning or his own laundry. Therefore, the need for him to go out into the community and go grocery shopping has been taken away from him. Derek has limited funds available to him to spend, as a majority of his pension goes to Jacana to pay for his accommodation and support. Any spending money he does have gets sent by the public trust directly to Jacana. Therefore, the need for him to go to the bank to withdraw his spending money has been taken away from him. When he needs to see a doctor, he sees a doctor that's employed at Jacana. Therefore, the need for him to see a GP in the community has been taken away from him. With limited spending money and limited opportunities to go out in the community, Derek's hair is often cut at Jacana. Therefore, the need for him to regularly visit a hairdresser in the community has been taken away from him. Jacana provides in-house opportunities for Derek to have a drink at happy hour on Friday afternoon, attend church, or participate in recreational activities. Therefore, the need for Derek to go out in the community, do these things, and engage with people outside Jacana has been taken away from him. Taking these things away from Derek has robbed him of the opportunities to do ordinary things and to have an ordinary life. Therefore, what should be ordinary has become exceptional. The value roles Derek held before his accident, partner, father, employee, family member, friend, community member, and contributor have been eroded away during the years he has been at Jacana. Years of institutionalisation has devastated Derek's social landscape. Years of isolation has left Derek deprived of a wide range of relationships and opportunities with others that you and I would take for granted. No longer does he have the private, personal, intimate relationships he once had. In addition to this, he no longer has the casual day-to-day contact with community members and acquaintances. The neighbour across the road who waves to you when you're getting your mail, the bus driver who has a spontaneous chat with you when you get on the bus, the shop attendant who asks how your day was, your hairdresser who makes general chit-chat with you while you're getting your hair cut, the receptionist at the doctor surgery who's gotten to know you and has a conversation with you. And the list goes on. In Derek's exceptional day, he had the opportunity to engage in some of these casual day-to-day contacts with people in his local shopping centre, the sales assistants and the hairdresser. Both the private relationships and the casual day-to-day contact with community members have a legitimate and important place in a person's life, in a person's sense of belonging and a connection to an area. For that exceptional day, Derek was no longer a patient or a client of Jacana. He was a community member doing very ordinary and natural things. He was accepted and respected by those around him for a short period of time. Derek was included and part of life outside of Jacana. His day had purpose. A shift needs to be made from viewing Derek as a patient or a client to seeing him as a unique individual, a man who has hopes and dreams for the future, interests, desires, wants and needs, which are not and cannot be met by the Jacana facility and the service they provide. I ask the question, what would it take to make Derek's exceptional day an ordinary everyday life for him? Appropriate housing and sufficient individual funding so Derek can start to have choice and control over his support and life. For you here today and for the general community to say that Australia is a wealthy nation, despite what our current politicians may say, and it's not acceptable that someone in Derek's situation has to remain in a hospital environment 14 years longer than needed waiting for essential community services. That as a valued human being and as a citizen, he has a right to a life of quality in the community, a right to housing and support, a right to dignity, respect, privacy, a right to all types of social relationships. An acknowledgement that institutions are still prevalent today and not a closed chapter of our history. A commitment that Derek will no longer be forgotten. Now I'd like to hand over to Derek to say some final words.
What do you want for the future?
Bed.
And what does that mean?
Do you want to Washington?
Do you want Washington?
Move back to the community.
Not a good community. Have your own house?
Yeah.
How often do you go out, like to the shops or something like that?
Never.
Do you spend all your time at Chicana? Do you get bored?
Thank you.